the ultrasound tech was gone for a long time. I suspected something was not quite usual about our scan. And that's when he told me that it looked like she had spina bifida. We were scared because we didn't know what that would mean for her.
Spina bifida is a term used to describe a large number of disorders. All the disorders are disorders of development of the central nervous system. This occurs very early as the embryo is being formed.
Brittany was the perfect candidate for fetal surgery here at Nationwide Children's Hospital.
Really having that distinguished opportunity to be able to go in, into the uterus, into the womb, to start caring for children so that we can change their trajectory of life.
It's clear that fetuses that get repaired before birth are twice as likely to walk without support, half as likely to need a shunt, a tube that connects the ventricles in the brain to the abdomen.
It was just very clear. I know what's wrong with her, and I know what I could do to fix it. The potential to get her brain back into the right position, to get her spinal cord covered. We decided to move forward with surgery.
See you soon.
Fetal surgery is a team sport. And the cool thing is we bring experts from all different specialties together. We have the mother to care for, so we have the obstetric nurses, we have the fetal surgeons, we have the cardiologists in there with ultrasound monitoring the fetal heart because we're doing a spina bifida repair. The neurosurgeons were there.
Once the maternal fetal medicine surgeons have found the baby, found the defect, I perform the three-layered closure. Close the covering of the dura, close the skin and subcutaneous tissue.
Everything was really well put together. Having that comprehensive team is key for a successful operation.
It went really well, and next thing I knew, I was up in recovery. Our MRI results showed that the surgery did exactly what it was supposed to do.
The MRI showed restoration of the brainstem to its normal location. So more importantly, we did not see enlargement of the ventricles, the fluid that collects within the brain that puts them at risk for hydrocephalus. So all the things that we really wanted to see to ensure that we had a perfect outcome were the things that MRI revealed.
We always knew we wanted to do this surgery, but seeing the benefits, even before she was born, they were unbelievable.
One of the major concerns when you've had surgery in your uterus is preterm labor. Remember, the womb is the best intensive care for a fetus, and so keeping that fetus there all the while is key. We did this surgery at about 25 weeks, and so for Brittany, we wanted the pregnancy to go as far as it could. We were hoping for 30, 32, 34, 37, and Brittany made it all the way to 37 weeks. The C-section is something that we plan for every patient that's had open fetal surgery. The reason for that is because of that incision on the uterus. We don't want the uterus going into contractions. In the case of Brittany, the scar was actually at the back of her uterus, so we made a new incision in front to get the baby out.
The first time she cried, it was the littlest cry, and then I started crying, and then Jared started crying because we were just so happy.
Once the baby was out and was doing fine, we could then go to the back and check on that incision.
We put in dissolvable sutures, some of which were still there, but the incision was flat, well healed, and completely closed.
One of the best things about getting the surgery beforehand, the incision had all of this time to heal. We could hold her.
If we didn't have a fetal center, she would have to be immediately transferred here. Mom and baby were together. Lexi is in there looking like a perfectly normal newborn with a scar on her back.
Lexi was born a term. She didn't need all the support that a premature infant would need. So Lexi and Brittany could actually get discharged home together.
I can't imagine delivering anywhere else. Our doctors are so knowledgeable. We couldn't have asked for a better team of people.
What we did was assemble a dream team. People that had decades of experience in fetal care in different places, and then integrating them with the team that was already present here. So what's next for Brittany and Lexi? Well, they're part of our family now, and we continue to follow Lexi all the way into adulthood.
There's a very high likelihood Lexi will walk.
Just seeing her legs move gives us a lot of hope. I think we would be in a totally different position if we had not done the surgery beforehand. She's beyond what we could have imagined.